Hey friends, welcome back to the channel and happy new year's to everyone. I'm Donal, a senior software engineer and AI specialist based in Sydney. And today I'm going to show you a demo and a tutorial on how to build a knowledge retrieval chatbot that can answer any question about specific documents, website pages such as FAQ, or even other resources like Notion or Confluence. At the end of the video, you will be able to deploy it to production and embed it in any website you want, so stay on board. You also don't need any coding skills as the code is already done and only small modifications are necessary to adapt it to your own use case. I will be using Voiceflow for the interface, LangChain from the knowledge retrieval that we will expose as an API with LangServe and Replit to host the API. This allows to have full control of the tools used such as the vector store, LLMs, retrieval method, chunking method, etc, etc. First, let's look at what we are building with a quick demo. In the code, I used this specific article from Medical Express, and you will find a link in the description of this video, and ingest its content into my knowledge base. That article talks about the discovery of a new tool called iStar that helps detecting tumors and cancer cells with AI vision. As you can see here, if I ask a simple question like, what is iStar, it will automatically answer based on that article. This can be embedded directly on a website, built natively or with CMS like WordPress, with the export feature of Voiceflow. As always, all of the links and instructions will be written in the description of this video. Now let's see how this is done, and the first step is building the Voiceflow. I won't be spending too much time on Voiceflow here to not make the video too long. If you want me to make a full video explaining Voiceflow, please let me know in the comments, and I will gladly do so. This is the starting point, and I simply show I am an AI assistant powered by a custom knowledge base. Ask me anything or click a button below. In there, I have the ask a question button that directly redirects to the next block, and I also have created an intent that redirects every request of users asking a question to that exact same block. When the user type anything like I have a question or any similar text, the next block will be triggered. Once that block is triggered, I show ask any question and I will provide a response from my knowledge base and capture the user reply in the last utterance variable. I will send that to my custom API as a post request to this specific URL, and I set the headers to content type as parameter key and application slash JSON as value because I am sending a formatted JSON object. As a parameter, I have the input with the question of the user, so here I can add input and last utterance. On the body, I can select raw and I have the following code. Here I just specify the input to last utterance. Finally, I catch the output response and set the last response variable to the response sent back by the API. The last step is to simply display the last response field and two buttons. One to ask another question and one to end the conversation. Now that we have seen how the Voiceflow is built, let's look at building the API. I'm building the API with LangServe to host the API. I'm using Replit, and a link of it will be available in the description of the video for you to get access and fork the project directly. In order to build that API, I'm using LangServe from LangChain. It allows to easily create API. The full API can be developed under 80 lines of code, as you can see here. Everything happens in the main.py file. In the ingest docs function, we are ingesting the documents. And in this example, I am directly fetching the documents from a specific URL that is the article you just saw before. And there you can directly specify which CSS class you want to extract. This could be particularly useful for FAQ, for example. Here I am selecting the news article CSS class, as you can see. I got that from inspecting the page and looking at what CSS class the article is in. You want to get as close as possible to the text of the document to avoid having any HTML and CSS code in there. You can use other document loaders if you want here. To have the full list, you can go to the following website and click on the one you need. You can then change the content of that function according to your need. Once I get the content, I can create my chunks and save them in a vector store. If you don't know what I'm talking about here, I made a specific video about it and would highly recommend you to watch it after this one to understand the concepts better. Now it's the main part of the algorithm. First, it checks if the vector store exists. If it doesn't, it will call the ingest docs method. Then I create the retriever and get the prompt. Here I use the Langchain Hub, which is a place where I can find thousands of prompts already made, and you can directly load them into your code with the following method. I then instantiate my LLM with GPT 3.5 Turbo and my temperature to zero to avoid any randomness. After that, I have my RAG chain that uses LCEL, which is Langchain Expression Language. This chain is a bit tricky to apprehend as LCEL and pipes can be confusing, but it's basically replacing the necessary variable in the prompt. To be more precise, in my prompt, I have a question and a context variable. The question variable will be taken from the input parameter passed to the chain. The retriever will also use that input parameter to return the most relevant documents and chunks, and then pass this inside format docs to format them accordingly. While this might sound complicated, if you check the documentation right here, you can see that this is the common way of using retrievers with LCEL. Now that I have my RAG chain created, I need to expose it with an API. For that, I'm gonna use FastAPI and add a new route. The first parameter is app, the FastAPI variable I created. The second one is the chain, the RAG chain, and the last one is the path to access that API. A full guide will be available in the description of this video as well. Now let's see how to deploy the API. The first thing you need to do is to fork the replit. For that, you can directly click on this link right here and then on fork on the top right. The next step is to delete any files vector.db folder if present, as you want to go with a new database, a new vector store. Then click on secrets on the left to add your OpenAI API key with the one that you got from platform.openai.com. Then go to the left side and click on shell and type poetry install to install all of the needed dependencies. Now, if you want to load documents from a docs folder, uncomment the directly loader and comment the web-based loader code. Import the right class and put all of your document in there. Otherwise, if you want to load text from a URL, just change the URL and add the specific CSS class you want to read from. In this example, we are only loading the content inside news article, as I showed before. Then click on run and everything should be green. You can then enter the web view and go to /knowledge/playground on the top right. And you can see a playground option where you can add your question and click on start. It should then show the output of the query. Once it is working, you have to deploy the solution to be able to use it in Voiceflow. To do that, first you can stop your server by clicking on stop and then click on deploy on the top right. You might have to add your credit card details in there, but it should not cost you too much money to deploy it for a quick time. Once you click on deploy, check that you are doing autoscale and click on set up your deployment. Then set the max number of machines to 1 to use less credits, and you might need to increase it later. Now click on approve and configure build setting, write down the primary domain, check that the run command contains the right command, which should be the following, and that your OpenAI API key is set. Then click on deploy. You will then have to wait for a bit and hopefully get everything green and deployed. You can then get the URL and copy it on Voiceflow. Once this is done, the whole chatbot should be fully working. Also, after you use it, don't forget to turn the server off if you don't want to run it 24/7 to save on credits. And for that, you have to go to settings and click on shutdown. And then yes, delete my deployment. That was a lot of things to digest in this video, so if you want to try it out, I would recommend to get the different links in the description of the video, and there you will have a document with everything summarized for you to access. In the next videos, we will see how to add more to the chatbots with features like chat history or loading documents from multiple sources. If you have any questions, comments, or specific topics to discuss, don't hesitate to let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.